Hello YouTube, I'm back again with another video, and today we're going to work on my 2018 Polaris Sportsman 450 HOEFI. I don't know if that means anything different, if that wasn't there or not, but this video is going to be for the company where I bought this oiler here, Tusk wheel bearing greaser front and rear. Okay, that's what she looks like, and this is the package. I haven't used it yet, and as you can tell, it's still new, but I did some measurements and I got a gut feeling that this won't work on the front, but this will work on the back. So, as you can see, I'm using my brand new Harbor Freight jack to lift up the four-wheeler. Thing is awesome. I lift it way up there. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and take the we're going to start the back this time, and I want to see if that greaser will work. I'm having issues of people saying that their greasers work for this four-wheeler, and they don't. So this is my second attempt, and let's go see if it fits. Alrighty, we have the tire off, we got the hub pulled out, and here it is, the Tusk wheel bearing greaser. Thing's brand new, I haven't used it yet. Okay, here's what I want to do before I get this thing dirty and try to see if it fits. I'm going to take this digital caliper, brand spanking new caliper, go ahead and turn it on, and we're going to zero that out. It's in millimeters, and we're going to go ahead and open up and see what we got on the inside here. Alright, on this Tusk greaser, it's 30 millimeters on the inside of the bearing greaser. That's good news, because this has to fit, the axle has to fit through that. Now we'll put this over here. Oh, that's plenty of room, because the axle itself, go ahead and do her up here, is 28 millimeters or 29. So that should just fit right in there beautifully. Now the second measurement I want to do, go ahead and zero this back out, is around here. So we're going to go ahead and open this up. And I'm not hitting the rubber gasket or O-ring when I do the measurements here. It is approximately 40 millimeters round. So now when I measure my rotor here, let's go ahead and do this up real quick. It's 40, so that's telling me that greaser will work for the back. That is awesome. So, okay, we'll go ahead and shut this off, this caliper. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna push this in. They say to put a little bit of grease around this, so I'll take some of this fresh grease and put around it. A little bit there. And we're gonna go ahead and stick it in there. Oh, that fits in there nice. Really nice. So let's go into the workshop and grab my DeWalt greaser. I love this thing. Put it down right there. Take my cap off. Hook it up. Okay, let's see if we can grease her up. Okay, there it comes. Around there. Okay. That is fantastic. Fantastic. So we got this greased. Look at that nice fresh grease in that wheel bearing. Thank you, Tusk. Like I said, I've been ordering so many of these online. So far, this is the only one that works in the back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all this together. And I think we're going to start the front. We'll see if the front works. So, okay. Alright, I got everything almost put back together again. I written down all the torque specs for doing this here. Now, the lug nuts are 27 foot-pounds to hold the tire. The castle nut is 110 foot-pounds. And then the caliper nuts are 23 foot-pounds of torque for here. And the wrench you're going to need, I don't know if I explained this yet, is a 14 millimeter open-end wrench. Open end wrench is for the bottom one, and you can use a socket, a small socket with a wrench here, as you can see over there, for that. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and, this is just hand tight right now, go ahead and put 110 foot-pounds, and I spray painted this blue so I can remember the size of this. It's a 27 millimeter castle nut socket. So we're gonna go ahead and torque that down. I got my torque wrench right here. It's all set to go. We're gonna go ahead and tighten her up. There it is, 110 pounds right there on that nut, castle nut. Yep, feels pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this up. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other back before I do the front over here, so I can get this whole rear end greased on the four-wheeler, and we'll work on the front. All right, we're on the rear left, if you're sitting on it. I got everything hooked up, ready to grease. And I'm used to greasing cars up. I thought there was another rotor. It's just the hub right here. Oh, that's a lot easier. Don't have to worry about that caliper. It's only on the one side. So yeah, that's awesome. So I'm gonna go ahead, there's my grease gun again. I'm gonna go ahead and I want you to watch right around and through here, see if there's any grease coming out. There it comes. Nice. And that's all you want. Yeah, those things were empty. So, alright, so now the back will be done. I'm going to see if there's any grease fittings anywhere else on this side. And there should be. Greased up. I'm going to put the back tire on. Then we'll go to the front. Alrighty, now we're on the front of the four-wheeler. And again, we are working on the Polaris 2018 Sportsman 450 HOEFI. Okay. So, now to take off the front caliper, you need a 13 millimeter socket or open-end wrench. The backs are 14. Not understanding why they changed it, but just to make it difficult for the average person to work on it, I guess. So we're gonna go ahead and loosen that up. I already got the cotter key out of here, or cotter pin. Yeah, I'll show you. Got this out. I haven't taken this off yet. I'm gonna wait until I get the caliper off, and we'll go from there. Hey, we're gonna pull it off. There it is. I just threw grease in there from the last time I pulled this off because I was worried about that, because I had this apart and the other greasers that I bought would not fit inside there. So what we're going to do before we even attempt to put that Tusk greaser in and see if it works, we're going to take this to the workshop and we're going to grab the calipers. Got the caliper. Come into the workshop. Let me turn off this fan here. And we're going to go ahead and see before I even tempt this. We're going to go ahead and zero it out. We are going to measure the outer diameter of the front rotor. So we're going to go ahead and put it right about there. It is 34, most likely 35. Okay, so that's what that looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and take pictures of this here so I have it for reference. And now we're gonna measure the inside. Okay, let's come around here. And it's 23.88. Oh boy. Let's try this again here. Yeah. Scratch that. It's 24.64. So I don't know if that tool is going to work or not. Well, we'll find out. I'm going to go ahead and take pictures of this real quick. I'll be back. Okay, we have the Tusk greaser. You can see I've been using it. I am very pleased with this for the back. But on the packaging it says front or rear. Let's see if this will fit in there. Okay, that's one good news, that the axle fits in with no problem. But if you look, it will not fit in there at all. It will not fit because this outer shell of this is bigger than the rotor itself. Look at that. You can tell the difference. I have to have a 35 diameter round to fit in here. It will not fit at all. So this is the reason why I'm making this video for the company Tusk. because it does not fit the 2018 Polaris 450 Sportsman HOEFI. So if there's any way you can contact me and help me out, I am definitely going to keep this greaser for the back, but I need one for the front. The axle fits in there fine inside there, as you can see, but it will not go in where the hub goes in. This is too big. So, alrighty, well, I'm going to end it here. And I'm going to just go throw some grease in there real quick. Grease up the front end. So all I have to do later is grease the bearings if I ever get a greaser that will fit in here. I need a 35 millimeter diameter around this. It looks just like this. So, alrighty guys, thanks for watching, and I'll be talking to you.